So today we'll start. Today we have an interesting topic is how to increase consciousness. Okay, and first of all, I'd like to thank the Health Library, Dr. Aniruddha Malpani, who gives us the continuous opportunities to speak on various topics. And I have been a very regular speaker here. Almost every month, I have my talks, which are uploaded on the YouTube. So I would also like to thank all the audience and all the people who are here, who regularly come for my talks and who regularly watch my talks everywhere in India, all over the world. So a big thanks and heartfelt gratitude to them. So I will now start my topic. So if you just want to quickly note down the details, you can. This is my WhatsApp number and my email ID. And any doubts you have, you can always connect to me on both these contact numbers and email IDs. So let's start. We start with energy first. There's a beautiful slide which says that everything is energy. What do you mean by energy? Why we say everything is energy? We see each other as human bodies. We see each other as a matter form or a we try to compare each other how they look, but finally everything today is made up of energy. Why we say so?
Not the option.
No, it's not like that. This is just a start of way.
So Siri should give any answer. Siri, answer them.
Everything is made up of atoms and vibration.
Yes, yes. But finally what they have in them is an energy.
Yeah, okay. Vibration.
Yes, energy is there everywhere. It is omnipresent everywhere. And if we connect with this energy, we connect with different aspects of this energy, which in tune connect us with the different aspects of the cosmic energy or the different vibrations of the cosmic energy. And what we call is God, which is because God is omnipresent everywhere. So even understanding everything as energy will take you very, very close, because at that time you will never be connected to a human body or whatever is there inside the human body. You are vast and you are just infinite. You're not limited energy, you're unlimited energy. Okay, so we'll see the second part. It's a beautiful slide again. I always find good slides because the creative part in me has just illuminated, and so it helps me to get some good slides, you know, because many a times images speak a lot when we don't require words, because we go into thinking mode. Thinking doesn't mean my mind. Thinking has various ways where we can analyze, and we look at this slide. It just shows one bulb which is illuminated or which is lighted, and the other bulbs are just lying like that. Okay, if we connect this with our lives, I can say this one bulb which is just open is like a soul which has ignited himself or herself, and the other ones which are just lying. But this one bulb, if you can see, it's trying to spread some light to the other parts also. It's reflecting. So depending on the openness that you have, okay, how good are your energies and how good are your receptibilities, you will be able to open your own lights. It's always said that the guru is someone who guides you to a path, but after a while you have to ignite your own lights and to totally illuminate yourself from the inside, because finally we are divine. We are nothing like a human or anything. We all are just too much divine. But it's just that we do not want to accept that we are divine. We like to play many roles in our life, like in movies. Sometimes we play like villains or some side roles. But why can't we play the role which is universal and which does not have any mind, and that's called as a divine role. So we can play a role like this, like a divine role, and slowly, slowly, by increased consciousness, we'll be able to touch not just one but many lives. Now, I always have these slides in many of my sessions, that it said that the atom is about 99.9% empty space, what you feel inside it determines your consciousness level. So many a times I've seen that this consciousness is blocked by various factors like disbeliefs, having wrong notions, or having a lot of negative thoughts. So all these depleted energies, they block your consciousness, and it doesn't allow to flow the way it should. Because like I said just a little earlier, like, we are all divine, but the only thing is we are not ready to accept this quality, because these negative things and this blocks us so much, they stop us from reaching that. So even if we start working slowly in our energies, we will start realizing that what we are looking for solutions is outside, and what we are looking for counseling outside, it's actually inside. It's not required to go anywhere out. You just need to find it within. So all these atoms inside, there are so many atoms and molecules inside us. It's like we are made up of innumerous count of cells. We are made up of the nucleus, we are made up of the atoms, the molecules. So unlimited is the potentiality which is there inside. So why can't it just come outside? Why can't this empty spaces be filled with pure consciousness and pure divinity? It is possible. You do not have to leave anything to come and be a divine. You just have to be alert and aware. And consciousness is the first step which will take you towards this alertness and awareness. We'll see the next slide, and now we'll see how various ways, and I have found very simple ways where everyone can relate, not just that only spiritual people will be able to understand, but it's not so. Even a common man or someone who is just on the pedestal to explore his life can also understand this very, very easy. And we start with various ways. As the first thing what I would start is love. Okay. So I just have a very good groups which I broadcast messages every day, and I just sent one message today, and just a while back it just came to me in my consciousness because I was alert. It just came, and some angel wanted to give me this message, and she just said the message I just understood in my intuition, and it's love is the expansion of the soul. So the essence of love, it's just not essence, it's actually the incense. The connection with love will make you connect with lot of divine and celestial beings. We have angels present in this room itself. But if the essence and the incense is ignited, or it's connected with these feelings of love, not just love which is connected with the human beings, but love which is connected with the divine, what we called as a universal fact. You'll be able to connect with these small messages that come to you. And you may be doing just your work, or you may be in your business, you may be in your job, or you may be doing or cooking food, just doing your regular activities. No need to leave everything and just become something like a divine. It's not a definition anymore. You can just be like this and explore all your divine qualities, and all these points will be delivered to you. Just being connecting with the pure form of love. Love doesn't mean that I have to connect with some relation or anything, but just pure. Okay, so this is one way where we can explore the consciousness. And love for whom? Is love for the people, love for the places, or love for situations? But love starts with your own self. Okay, I just found this image while I was just making this amending this presentation in the morning, and I just found these this beautiful image, and it's one of my dream to go towards the higher peaks of Himalayas and just do nothing, just be surrendered to the divine. And I just, in my consciousness, I just got this image. It's so wonderful. It says that I am surrendered, or I am surrendered to myself, and the divine is within me, and I surrender to this divine. It's so beautifully said, So we get moments like this throughout our day. It doesn't mean that every time we have to go to the Himalayas to experience this moment. It's not required. Throughout the day, we can catch up these small moments, These can be for 5 minutes, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, wherever you are, just find these moments. I always say through my Facebook messages and all, like, don't create memories, because memories will create a lot of attachments and a lot of emotions that at times cannot be handled. Create only moments, because moments are just there for a while. Just create that moment, enjoy, and just go ahead. Okay. So the first thing what you need to do is completely love yourself. If we want to break free from whatever is happening in your life right now, please, please, please start loving yourself first. So that's the first way that can open the channel of your consciousness. And trust the vibe that you get, because energy doesn't lie. There are times when people are just surrounded by negative people, this negative psychic vibes that you keep on getting. So stay away from that, because energy doesn't lie. The moment you get that vibe, you disconnect, because there are various ways you can connect with good energies. But continuously, if you are in a negative circuit or in a group of negative people, you are going to absorb that in your aura. And it's always said that your vibe attracts your tribe. That means if you have a positive vibe and if you have a very high consciousness energy, you will attract only those people. So if you see that if you are wanting to have something in your life will just automatically change. You do not need to do anything to change our life, the way we are thinking, how can we manifest things. It just happens on a very, very, very auto mode. Okay, because why I'm saying is the subconscious mind is very, very powerful. It's 30,000 times powerful than the conscious mind. So if we connect with these kind of factors, and if we start loving ourselves, the subconscious mind has those imprints and has those memories. You do not have to try to fit in the mind, because the energy in this form of images and this form of emotions and feelings is enclosed inside your subconscious mind. And your subconscious mind is like a large and very huge storage, and it has a capacity to store anything that you want. So why not good energy, and why not good feelings about your own self? Because that's going to help you when you're down. When your graph goes down, like an ECG graph, it's always, you know, it's like up and down. Okay, so when your graph goes down, the subconscious movements will start emitting out, like, you know, frequencies which will connect you to that part of you which you experienced a while back, and that will not allow you to deplete down. So your own consciousness will at times uplift you if you use love as your incense and essence. And if you start using it, you will, you know, feel the presence of angels here. You will start getting their fragrances. And many a times, they give you a lot of ideas and inspirations. You know, like just in the morning when I was doing a lot of work, I was doing around 15 works at a time. And I don't know how I managed. I managed to do that in 2 hours of time. Everything I finished, and I just got of good ideas and inspirations. You know, it just came in my consciousness, and I also noted down those ideas, because it's essential that I pen down whatever I got it. And it just came in a while. I did not have to ponder or think about it. Now it's up to me how I convert these ideas and inspirations, because somewhere it has to be given. When I am given so much as unlimited, I also have to give it unlimited. Okay, so this fact of giving and receiving will create a total balance. It will balance your yin and yang. So another factor is this photo I clicked. It was just outside a Durga Puja pandal. I go for Durga Puja every year, and I just went inside and I prayed to Ma Durga, and I came out, and while going inside, I saw this child and these beggars were, you know, and these vendors were trying to sell on the roadside. And while coming out, while going in, I just went in, and while coming out, I saw. And this lady, she had one baby on her lap, and that was another child which was very, very small, and they were trying to sell some goods. But I did not see at the goods part or anything. My only attention went was to this child. This child was crying a lot. Maybe he was very hungry, and because his parents had to sell all these goods to make money, they were not giving him attention. So I just figured out that one thing is, he is not interested in whatever is happening. All he needs is food or something to put in his mouth so that he will feel better. Okay, so I just quickly went. I thought maybe if I give him some biscuits and all, he's maybe not be that happy. So I thought, let me give him a chocolate. So I just quickly went. I just grabbed 2-3 packets of chocolate and I gave it to him. So that chocolate is there in his hand. And when I gave it to him, I opened it and I gave it to him. And his even parents were looking at me, and So I told him, like, told his parents, like, why don't you tell the child to eat, because I think he's not understanding me. So he was just looking at me, he had tears in his eyes, and for a while he was surprised that he had food in his hand. So even that that small thing what I did even expanded my love. You see, love is there everywhere. Why I just need to find out in you know, specific relations like mother, father, and a husband, wife, and a boyfriend or a girlfriend. It's just there, you know. It expanded my heart, and this image I try to put wherever I can. Even by doing this, it shifted my consciousness just a little bit high, maybe at that time. I mean, at the Durga Puja Pandal outside, if like people can at least just look at it, you know, it can shift a lot of consciousness. Okay. So, because what we think we become, because if we have these kind of thoughts, it's going to liberate us. Okay, because a small revolution inside us will create a very great evolution in a very short span of time. Okay. And another way is become silent. Okay. Silent means don't do anything, just be with yourself, you know, like you might want to laugh, you laugh, it doesn't mean that you have to shut your eyes. One way is to meditate just by doing nothing. The best way is you can go in the mother nature, or you can go in a garden where, or on a beach where you are connected with the natural energies, and just hear the natural sounds and just, you know, merge with them and just do nothing, and just that act of doing nothingness will take you to that level where you will learn to meditate. You know, there's no particular way to meditate, and I always say that passive meditations are the best meditations, but nowadays we do a lot of guided meditations because it's very difficult for people to stay in a passive state. So meditation is also a way to increase your consciousness, but meditation doesn't mean that you have to meditate for long hours. You can split that 1 hour also in 10 minutes. You can do it for 3 to 4 times a day, or you can actually do it for 5 minutes whenever you get time. But that's a way you can get connected with your consciousness, because that meditation will take you inside, which at many a times you will get a lot of thoughts and not thoughts but intuitions or inspirations which with the eyes open you might not get. Okay. And there are other ways, other benefits also to meditate. When we meditate is our body functions and our body anxiety or any negative stress or anything is much reduced. So even our body benefits from it. And the another way is earthing. Nowadays we are you know, disconnected from this process of earthing is because we are living in a very concrete world where everywhere you see buildings, and you know, hardly only just in some parts, like in, you know, oasis, like it's like Bombay has become like an oasis where you hardly see some greens, you know. But there are certain sections in Bombay, like, you know, Varsova, if you see a lot of greenery, or if you see this side, you know, towards the Kulaba or the Cuff Parade, you will see a lot of greenery, which some parts really have these patches. So it's like I would call Bombay has become a lot of oasis. But there are times when you can just go in the nature, you know, don't be afraid that your feet will, you know, have those muck or it will get dirty and all that. But that's a process where even the earthing can connect you with the earth's energies which are there, you know. So the process of absorbing earth's free flowing electrons from its surface through the soles of 1 feet. So you will get connected with the Mother Earth. The energies which are coming from the down, it will be connected to you. So even in your home, you try not to wear any socks or not to wear any slippers or anything. Try to be bare feet. I know there are times when it's extremely cold, so you have to wear something. So that time it's okay, but at least sometime in the day, try to, if you have a small garden or something, if you your building has a garden or your home has a garden, you try to connect and try walking bare feet on that. Even that small act will connect you with the Mother Earth, where some points of consciousness or some factors of consciousness can be ignited. These are very, very simple ways. And throughout the day, I'm sure we can at least give 5 to 10 minutes to it. Then the full moon. Okay, we have this every month which is there. So the full moon and the new moon, they have a lot of energies. When you, it's said that if you have some wishes and if you meditate at these times, there are higher chances that your wishes can manifest. Why? Because of the energy, not because the moon is something who is sitting there to grant you the wishes, you know, it's not there to stamp you the wishes, because the energy is very high. So at that time, whatever thought you put in your subconscious mind, that creates a huge vibrations. And when those outside vibrations match with that, that starts manifesting. Okay, so that's also one way to do. Instead of, you know, wasting time sleeping, we can actually, you know, meditate for long, long hours during that time. Long hour doesn't mean at a stretch, but, you know, 15, 20 minutes, you can keep on meditating during that time. And there are a lot of meditation groups who have these meditations happening. So you can connect with these groups, you know, like-minded groups. Like I said, your vibe attracts your tribe. So try to connect with these type of groups. Okay, and meditate for... the humanity consciousness, for healing the Mother Earth, because that's what we are come here for. Our material needs will be met, don't worry about that. If we are surrendered to the divine, because it's a God omnipresent energy which is there everywhere, it will fulfill all your material needs. Whatever you require will be done. So try even to pray for not just world peace, but also that all the humanity consciousness, not just us or me, or just my family, but let everyone have an uplifted consciousness. Because if that is done, then only we will go to a higher dimensional world. Why just few people have to reach to the fifth dimensions, or why only few people are helped by the ascended masters to shift to a higher dimensions? Why not all? So if everyone today in this world is doing this type of healing consciousness and humanity healing consciousness meditations, I'm sure that very soon a lot of people will come into this consciousness states, and then they will start discovering their own selves. Okay, so very, very important. Then one more way is bless the water that you drink, because we are made up of water. We are made up of water, we are surrounded by water. If you see, Bombay is surrounded everywhere by water. We can't stay without water. Our blood has water, the brain has water, the bones also require the water. So everywhere the water is there. So there are times where the small child in some religions, they are blessed with this holy water, you know. So you can bless the water that you drink, you know, and that's also a way to increase the consciousness. What happens during this is the collective blessings, the energies that you put, or the prayers that you put in that water, creates a energy that goes inside your body, and that entire body, when it's filled with this energy, it ignites or opens those channels which are blocked by all these negative beliefs. So even this is a way. And we'll see one more thing, one more slide, where, you know, that is the photo of an ice crystal frozen from a severely polluted water. And on the photo on the right is the same water refrozen of having been blessed. Okay, it's by Dr. Emoto. I had shown this in my last lecture also. But you see the beautiful transformation of what has happened. See the shift of consciousness from this to this. So even we can do it if we bless the food that we eat, the water that we drink, and not just the water in the home, but water everywhere on this earth. Okay, one can plainly see that we have the ability not to heal ourselves, but to heal the earth as well. So you can heal along with the humanity consciousness. You can heal all the waters of the earth and everywhere. All these angels and divine beings, they are here to help us. These celestial beings are there to help us, so why not we start doing these small things. Okay, and this is the polluted and toxic water from Fujiwara dam, and the same water sample after offering and 1 hour prayer. You see the transformation that has happened. It's created a beautiful crystal. Okay, then happy World Water Day. I got this slide in the morning. Most of you is water, so love that water. We are made up of water, and also love the waters of the world. Just what message I gave you. And open all your divine channels, you know, start opening them up. Here if you see that there's no body here, okay, we can see your hand or anything, but there's no body, there is only one channel. And if you see, everything is merged in that channel, the universe, the cosmic, the water, everything is merged in that channel. So be one with all. Okay, so we say that we are made up of five elements, panchabhutas. So unite all those. These are the channels to open you, okay, and open your consciousness. And when you do that, the consciousness will just flow like this. Okay, when I meditate, when I find that I'm doing some intense meditations, and when I start just doing that, and they are a part of my sadhana also, and I just feel very, very hollow. There's absolute nothing. It's just a space. It's exactly like this. Okay, and I even get those images just what I want, because the mind exactly captures what I want to deliver, you know, because it's there within, so it comes outside. So from outside, I'm not taking inside. I'm from inside, I'm giving it outside. Then it's like a frequency. The God is a frequency. It exists within you. It's there inside me. Many a times we tune into our mobile radios, or at times when our mobiles or they don't have good network, you know, we try to adjust the frequencies and take it to a point where we, you know, get a reception. So similar ways, the God is a frequency which is embedded inside you. It's not any space or any place, where it's in the heart chakra or whether it's in my stomach. It's not something like that. It's there in all my cells, and it's in the form of an omnipresent and a very divine energy. So this frequency is there inside you. So try to tune in with these frequencies, you know, like various ways I told you. You can start connecting slowly with these frequencies, and then you will feel that it's as if like a self-talk with God every day. It's not something that God is a very, oh my God, how am I going to speak with God? Like if you see in the churches, like anything that we want to speak, we go to the Father and we say that. Many a times we can't say to other people, so we go to Father and say. So now Father is a representative of God. He's a divine being. So the similar ways you can have a self-talk with your own self, because that frequency totally exists within you. So you can just do the fine-tuning, and you can adjust whatever channels that you want to open. Sometimes you can open an angel music channel. You know, many a times I hear those angel musics happening. You know, they're very divine musics. This kind of music I've never heard, the harp musics which is there. Sometimes I hear something which is a very classical instrument which is just playing. I've never heard these instruments anywhere out. I can't, explain this experience. Just experience this. Then close your eyes and fall in love and stay there, you know, just doing nothing and just closing your eyes and having even that big smile on your face, you know, that's going to connect you with that parts of love which you may have experienced in different, times in your life. So, you know, can catch all those moments, even that can, you know, connect you with a lot of consciousness. And now let's see the definition. Actually, there's no definition, but just got this good slide. Consciousness has no religion, no belief, no ideology. I do not belong to any section, no gender, no sexuality, no race, no age, and no nationality. It doesn't belong to anyone. It doesn't belong to religion or spirituality. No sections. It's just pure and it's just there. Okay, and you are the consciousness. That's it. Okay, there are various ways. Depending on our levels of consciousness, we will define consciousness. Okay, so it's not a perfect definition as such. Okay. Now who wakes up? You or God? Who wakes up first? Let's keep it interactive. Who wakes up? Whatever you want to say, you can always say. Who wakes up? God.
Nobody
or you first?
Up.
Huh?
Nobody.
Anda pehle ka murga pehle.
Nahi.
If I say God is in with me, it's there in my breath. Okay, so at that time, it's you both are merged together. When I say God is in me, I am also merged with the God, na? Okay, this waking up is not like manual waking up. This waking up is a form of awakening. Okay, who wakes up? You or God? That means one, when I merge with God, I'm merged with the universal fact. So I do not need to manually awaken myself. I'm awakened. Okay. So it's a beautiful image. These are the small things, you know, but we are so much disconnected by our concrete lives, and we just maybe in our childhood we may have connected with these silly things, but even that's a way of you know, connecting with your inner child that can also highlight a lot of levels of consciousness in us. It's like simply he's not doing anything, he's just enjoying with his pet, simply not doing anything. You know, there are times when you will get some time where, you know, you will try to spend that time. Instead, try connecting with these simple parts and simple aspects of you, which you used to do it earlier, but somewhere you became big, so you stopped doing it. So you can connect with these parts, you know, you can go for a nature walk, and there are a lot of organizations which have these walks in the nature. So connect with these parts, you know, like spend an hour and two in these kind of energies and these kind of nature, so that you can start connecting with your own self, rather than, you know, connecting with people who are like, you know, gossip mongers and all. Please disconnect from all that, you know? So the small you can take nature trips, you can plan it on your own, okay? And God is omnipresent, it's there everywhere. So this children, they are so beautiful, they are so innocent, they are not worried about anything. See the expressions on their face, they are so divine. It doesn't have any definition on them. When they cry, they fully cry. When they laugh, they fully laugh. And when they love, they fully love. But as we start being, you know, building up and becoming big, we have our ways to define love, joy, happiness and laughter. Everywhere we need to define. Okay? So God is omnipresent as his presence everywhere. And don't forget, this is also very, very important. And don't forget to pray tonight, because God didn't forget to wake you up this morning. It gave you an opportunity to lead a tomorrow, what we call a tomorrow. Okay, or even what we call the present. It's given you an opportunity to take this breath, to have a wonderful life, to give you a wonderful family and loved ones. So please don't forget to pray. So a small prayer for the God is also very, very helpful. It will ignite your consciousness. Because you are not separate from the whole, you are one with the sun, the earth, the air. You don't have a life, you are the life, you are one with them. So the moment you stop yourself disintegrating from it, you become just one with them. Okay. And emotions, another way to increase higher levels of consciousness is choose your emotions very, very wisely. Because too much anger, it will also hamper your body. Apart from reducing your consciousness, grief, sadness, what you can do is when you have anger, do the opposite of it.
Laugh.
Yeah. When you know you're going to be anger, so just laugh. When you are grief, what is the opposite of sadness?
Happiness.
Happiness. Worry? What is the worry? Feel free. Okay. And stress?
Joy.
Exactly. And fear?
Happiness.
Okay. So you can transform these when you get these. So even that, doing that now, like just you said, laugh. That shifted your consciousness. Yes, absolutely. And why? Because this will block our chakras. This will what happen? Because the chakras are our storage points where a lot of energies. Right now, we are just going to talk about the seven. We have one more slide coming up where we can see the higher chakras also, more than these seven. And because these are also related with your DNAs, so people are stuck with the seven only, they are not going higher. So a lot of these chakras will be blocked, like the Muladhara will be blocked by fear. So if we remove the fear from here, the insecurities will go, the financial problems will also go. Any relationship issues because of fear, that will all go. Then this Muladhara, Swadhisthana, the sacral chakra will be blocked by guilt. So if you have feelings of guilt, release that. Okay, you are a divine being of God. So by doing that, this will balance the chakras. So these are your different energy centers. The solar chakra, it will be blocked by shame. Okay, and deals with your willpower. So the opened solar chakra will give you a lot of opportunities which will just come in front of you, because you have the power in you. Like the He-Man, or he says, I have the power. I have the power means I have it inside me, not outside. And the heart chakra, it is blocked by continuous grief or sadness. It may be because of situations, your loved ones, or some people just have the habit of being sad, you know, they feel good when they are sad, doing nothing, just see being sad. And nowadays people have the habit of watching so many serials and they start living in those serials because that lady is sad, so I'm feeling sad. So please stop seeing all these serials, and that's not your life, please. That's, you're made for something else, you know. So don't go by those stories, and mind loves stories a lot. So it will soon start catching it, and subconscious mind is like a vast storage, it will store it. So you see it, you catch it, you put it, and you attract the same thing. So don't complain God that why did you give me so much problems, because you attracted the same thing. And if we see to the higher chakras, it is blocked by illusion, attachment, and it is blocked by a lot of lies. So by just handling our emotions very, very clearly, you can even unlock the potential of all the chakras. And if we clear this, then we go to the higher ones. These are just the 22. There are more than that. Okay, so if you start igniting and illuminating, slowly all these chakras will be start opening up. So if you see, these are the third dimensional one, the fourth, and these are the transmuting towards the fifth dimensional chakras. Okay, there are times when you start going deeper and you ignite your consciousness and your awareness starts growing up, you come towards slowly you start igniting the lower earth chakras. This is grounded, and you start igniting these, and then when you have the connection with what of celestial beings like the ascended masters, there are many ascended masters who have who are here on this earth to help you. They would have gone and they would have been ignited, they would have become the Buddha, but they are here to help you. That's why they are called as ascended masters, like Mother Mary, Kuan Yin, Mahavatar, Babaji. They are all here to help you to transcend from the lower dimensions to the higher dimensions. So take this shift by igniting your consciousness levels. So these are the many chakras. Here only 22 are there. There are many more than that. So you can easily start igniting all these chakras. Then you become a divine being. You will have a lot of miracles happening then. You might, if you start igniting these, you will start seeing auras. You will start seeing auras of the people. Lot of divine things will start happening. Okay. And don't worry that even if these kind of things happen, you don't have to leave your life and loved ones and then you have to go somewhere. You don't have to do all that. You can stay in your life and do whatever you're doing. And this is what will happen. The divineness will merge with you. You will have a relation, a very good with nature. Nature will start talking with you. Even nowadays I've observed the birds come and they start talking with me. I have a conversation with them. You know, I earlier also had a conversation with them, but now, yeah. You know, they come, sometimes they talk, you know, they will just come. And the plants, they start talking with you. You know, it's like, because I've become one with them, I'm like a friend with them. Like, I love a lot of plants. I have a small mini garden also, and I spend at least 10 minutes to 15 minutes with my, in my garden. Like, it's just a way of connecting with them, because
garden means pots.
We have a backyard, so we have made
ground
it into floor. Ground floor. So we have converted that into a small garden. All these flowers and all we have kept there. So even they become so happy, you know, when I see them, because now those lights are ignited. When I see that same thing in them, it's like I'm just connecting with that energy there, and I feel a divine love there. So I don't have to find a human to find a divine love. It's just there in them also.
Wow.
So it's very wonderful. So this has just started happening up. Okay. Why? Because awareness has increased. So now what we have to do is we have to just shut this and just keep a single spark and take the journey inwards. Take it inside. Shut everything. Okay, so take a journey inwards to explore the higher levels. Now I'm coming to the higher levels of consciousness. And this is also very, very important. I do this before I sleep. It's a small child. I love giving examples of children because they have a lot of innocence, you know, because there's no factors where you can define the innocence of a child. Yes, and one of the secrets of a long and a fruitful life is to forgive everybody and everything every night before you go to bed. And specifically if you have unforgiveness towards people, I have recorded a series of meditations, of fear meditation, forgiveness meditations with, and a love expansion with ascended masters and angels, and even listening to those will help you to with your forgiveness and fears. So please forgive everyone. Even people have given you a lot of hurt, pain, please forgive them, because they are the first people you need to forgive. Because their energy will be stuck inside you. That will not ignite that part of light. And that potential of you will be depleted. Okay?
Yes.
Yeah, so please forgive everyone. Be free and just let go. This is also an installation. It's 2-3 images are combined. One of my friend is photographer, so he has done that. So I always take live examples. So just be free. You can see it's emptied, totally emptied. Okay. Even though I'm living a very regular world, I'm just right now I'm also alert. So I'm connected with my consciousness and alertness. Though a lot of things are happening in the background, it doesn't take me away from my awareness and consciousness. Then release and let go which doesn't serve you. Now here the unconscious mind will also come. So you can see there is a lot of darkness also is there. So by doing the forgiveness and gratitude, and I will come to the gratitude part also, that will help you to release all these lights that you have blocked, all these lights which were not ignited or illuminated. Okay, I've come to gratitude. Yes, Ravi Shankar, Sri Sri Ravi Shankar. He's just... he's one of my gurus. I have not learned from anyone, but I always like all the gurus.
You have no guru in particular?
No, I have not done anything.
You went for a pilgrimage. What guru?
I had gone to Himalayas. Okay, I had gone to Rishikesh just to experience things there, not to learn anything.
Huh? I've been there.
Okay, very nice. So I think he's just there in Rishikesh. They have some program there. So I've recently seen Shri Shri's videos also, and on the Facebook he has put. So very beautifully this message, it says that when gratitude in you stays and that very gratitude flows from you as grace. So it becomes like grace. It's so beautiful. Read it again. We'll read it again. When the gratitude in you stays, that very gratitude flows from you as grace. So it's your divine grace. So it's not like grace is means I go to an institute, I learn how to walk and talk. That's not grace. That's just manipulated grace. And this grace is divine. So it just keeps on flowing. It's just there. You don't have to, I don't need to put this button on or put that button on. Let the grace flow in. It's not going to be like that. It's a divine grace. It's a divine flow. Okay. So be thankful. Always, small thing, even wherever you're traveling, someone irritates you, say thank you, whatever it is. You might also have a same fight with the person, but at the end, say thank you. Okay. So keep these habits, forgiveness and having gratefulness or gratitude. These are the two keys to unlock the happiness and also consciousness. Because your mind is like a garden and your thoughts are like seeds. You can either grow flowers or either grow weeds. Whatever, it's up to you. Because even the garden is a great example. You can see the weeds also, you can see the flowers also. But the gardener, the caretaker, he has to remove the weeds in order the plants to grow up. He has to maintain that. So similarly, we'll have thoughts like these. So we have to be like the gardener. We have to unplug these things from our mind, which are just coming inside us. You can beautifully build a shield also around you to keep away from the negative empaths. The negative psychic energies, because there is lots around you which you can't see. Okay. Our life is an influence of mind and karma. Mind plays games and the karma plays roles. That's how we get life and that's how we reincarnate. Okay. If we come in consciousness, our alertness comes. So in this one life also, you do not need to take many, many, many lives. You may have taken many lives and your soul has come through many journeys. But in this one life, you can ignite that and you can deplete all the journeys of your soul and just become one with them, like angel, or you can be, you don't need a body for that. Okay. And just few days back, I saw a beautiful orb at my home. And it was just there for a while. I did not notice. It was a very small orb. It was of a golden yellow color light. It stayed there. And after I noticed, I looked at it for a while. I thought it will go because now I'm seeing at it. And it was there for a while. It was Archangel Metatron. Okay. And after that, it went away. And yesterday also when I was doing some recordings, I had invoked a couple of masters for that. So I saw their orbs. It was so beautiful. If I would have missed them, but just a small consciousness, I felt something. And I just saw that these beautiful orbs were there and these colors were so beautiful. I don't have a palette, where I can define that. In fact, I started doing paintings. Like in my last talk, I told that, I'll be exploring paintings. So, but I have explored a different aspect of paintings. I have started doing mandalas. Now these mandalas are energy expansions where you put energy in that, and wherever it goes and wherever you put it will expand energy. Okay, so I'll just have one short one which I'll just show you. I just painted this in the morning only. So
wow,
it's watercolor. Just yesterday I just did a short sketch, and today morning I just painted. Within 1 hour I finished it. So this is the consciousness which will flow. There's no form. For me this is formless. And there's a lot of energy in that, and wherever I will put it will blast the energy, because there's a lot of ascended masters connections with this. Okay, so like this I'm exploring a lot of different aspects of my creativity, and which has just blasted like anything. So I don't require, you know, I need to sit and do now. Earlier I had that, you know, I need to sit and do. Now it's not like that. I just sit and the 10 things are happening, and I just paint, I do my work. So like I just shared in the just while back, I was doing 15 things. Along with that, the painting was one of the things. So I just within, I think 2.5-3 hours, I just finished everything.
Amazing. You are amazing.
Yeah, thank you. And I'll show some more things after the lecture. And both can be healed. It can be healed, totally. And see this, if you light a lamp for someone else, don't be worried, because I need to get something from someone, to hi main kisi ke liye lamp light karungi, no need. It will also brighten your path. I have definitely done something for people, it's brightening my path. If I would have said that this is just my journey, I will just do for myself, I'm not going to share, and if I just stop that, it's not going to help me grow. Okay, so if I'm getting that unlimited you know, divine blessing, so why not share that? So it will be magnified 10,000 and unlimited times. Okay, and I just have created a broadcast group on WhatsApp, and I just every day whatever intuition comes and consciousness comes, I try to give these messages. And this is something just spontaneously came, and I just put it. You know, being crazy is a way to be free. You need to be crazy also, you need to love your life. And free ways lead to dream ways. You know, free ways, you need to be free. And wherever fear, whereas fear leads to problem and questions, the choice is yours. Don't try to change the destiny, don't try to change it or align it. If God is omnipresent in you, He will get the best from you. In a way, even karma and destiny will have no roles. Whatever is in my hand will have a no role. It will just go away because God is in with me. Okay, this will not play any role because this is destiny. Then Mother Teresa, not all of us can do great things, but if we can do small things with great love, even that can make a lot of change, a lot of change. And I always give example of children. So what if we love each other? Such a innocent you know, expression is there. Even looking at these expressions can make you smile. So you, instead of what's in your phone, you can have these you know, images which can just connect with you that time. And some more. Joy is expansion of the soul. So beautiful. I just found it on the Facebook in the morning. I said it's perfect for my topic today. So there's no definition here. Okay, it's just the movement, not the memory. Music of the soul is doing nothing, just free. Okay. And every morning dedicate few moments to breathe in who you truly are. Okay.
You explain this one.
Yeah.
Breathe in who are you truly.
Breathe in who you truly are. Jo aap ho, usse connect karo. Love yourself.
Lovely.
Like even if you are having a tea or a coffee in the morning, like take that 5 minutes for you. You know, just be, don't
like the Japanese do. There yeah. was these ceremonies.
Yeah, yeah. Celebrate
yeah.
life.
Yeah, you have no idea of the Japanese tea ceremony. They treat it as a worship.
Yeah.
Their music, their cleanliness, every sip they enjoy.
Yes, exactly. Even that breath you can enjoy. When the breath is going in, the breath
something
is coming out, you know. Experience that relationship of love inside you. It's beautiful, you know, it's really
yeah.
beautiful. And one type of breathing, even I'm going to have workshops on this, how to increase consciousness, where I'll tell, you know, 5-6 different ways, simple ways. I don't want any complex ways, you know. And this is one way you can do. Instant relaxation whenever you are tired. Inhale 4 counts, that means 1, 2, 3, 4. Hold for 4 counts. If you can't hold for 2 counts minimum, and exhale 4 counts, and do this 4 times. It will instantly energize you and relax you. Instant.
Except step number two, which cannot be done by patients with having BP or heart
trouble. No, no, no. You can just relax it.
I believe so. This is a doctor that told
me. Yeah, yeah. You see, this is just general. As per your health condition, you can ignore
that.
Step
number, that is called Recha cutting.
Yeah, Kumbha can't control.
And pranayama is being taught by the connection of breath. Is being teaching a lot. Pranayams, breathe deeply and repeat. The repetitions will make a lot of difference. And even this thing, I do this with my plants and my trees, whichever are there. We have a lot of coconut trees in our building. So I try to hug them, you know. There are times I've done a lot of madness and craziness. I have even named them. I talk with them as names. It's like you all have names, we all have names. I talk with them as names. Many a times I had tagged it, you know. So when I felt that people are not understanding, now I just don't tag that. I just talk with them and say, hello, how are you? Why are you so sad? You know, I'm there, let's enjoy. So it's like a self-talk actually I'm having with them. So even doing this can expand your heart chakra like anything. Like
Osho,
whatever darkness is there.
This is what Osho said.
Yes. See, like this, when you start increasing your consciousness, you will get connected with these universal masters and gurus. Yeah, whoever are there. And go outdoors, try to spend your time outdoors and connecting with the nature. So you can go for a lot of camps, nature camps. Nowadays a lot of adventure camps which are there, which take you to different various places where people don't experience, and explore it also, because that will put your attention on the alignment with the Gaia, or that is the Mother Earth. Okay, the beautiful connection with the Mother Earth. So if you are not having the time, like, you can go for these short outdoor trips and get connected. We will connect with the water element, the fire element, all the elements will get connected with you. And even this is a very beautiful photograph. Whoever has clicked it, I say thank you. It speaks a lot. I don't have to say anything here. I can just take a pause. And God is omnipresent everywhere in all beings. Just so much divine. I do not need a form to worship God. I'll just share a small experience. Like this 2016 started with a great note, but it also had one massive big fire at my home where I lost a lot of stuff in my home. And but the great lesson that I learned from it, it's almost 2 months now, and we lost almost everything in that. Yes, almost everything. And everyone was surprised at how can I be so normal in that case. And one day after I just started examining, while other was thinking I'm sad and I'm going to cry, I said, it doesn't matter, it was a moment, it's not a memory for me. So then I realized I was being disconnected from the form to be formless. That's the only message that I got. And then the connection with the Shiva and the absolute stillness started building up. So if I want, I can take it in a negative way, but if I want, I can take it and build myself and ignite that thing. It was devastated like beyond any means, just like I was glad that we both were saved, by me and my mom. So God is omnipresent everywhere in all the beings. It's so divine. So for me, this is God. Okay, so I don't need to go to a temple to worship God, for this is also God for me, you know. So the connection with the animals will take you there, and even, you know, simple things, beautiful. So doing nothing, such brings good happiness, you know. And eat colors in your diet, you know. Even that will connect you and, you know, remove all these blockages, because they have all energies. These foods have good energies. So you can incorporate that in your diet, you know, all these greens, the whites, the reds, because these are also the colors of our chakras. Okay, it's always said that if you want to balance your muladhara, try to eat something red, or balance that redness of the color. There are many color therapies and all food therapies are there. Naturopathy is there. So even balancing your food is going to increase your consciousness. Because if you're going to eat more of fried and junk food, that's not going to increase the consciousness level. So you can have a balanced diet, nutritious food, not overcook it. Yoga, exercise that can open your body channels and vitality inside you. Okay. The education for the soul is healing the new paradigm. Yani, you must heal your body also to disconnect yourself from it. Because if you're just connected with the body, how will you ignite the consciousness? And again, angels play a big role here. Like I was always connected with the angels since the childhood. Like I always loved the gardens and I always felt there are some divine beings, but I never knew that. And I think since the last 15-16 years, like I've been being more connecting with the angels, and now it's just very, very, very strong. All the time they give me messages in the form of signs, numbers, feathers, and sometimes I just feel it. It's there. Sometimes the breeze of air from nothingness, nowhereness, it just comes to me. So all these messages have started coming up because I have ignited my consciousness. Okay. And by healing, your hands are full of divine energies. Just need to be clear of all these blockages which are there in your hands, because even they have a lot of chakras inside this. They are not just one, there are many of the chakras inside. And all these, slowly your consciousness will improve this. You will start finding out what it is. And you will be directed and you will be connected to a lot of gurus and masters also. Okay, so this is the way we need to do the healing. The healing also has to be done for the humanity consciousness, so that your heart chakra will start expanding and open all the, this is how the energy will come in. And everyone has access to this energy. So with the healing, you can open first your divine channels and do the healing for the universe. That is the universal humanity consciousness. And you can do the channelings also. She's my favorite and she's always there with me, the Kuan Yin, the Divine Mother, Kuan Yin. Okay. So she is the mother for love, compassion and mercy. And if someone is crying and if you start getting connected with the angels, she immediately hears the cries. So she will immediately come to you. That's another angel. I'm just showing you pictures. Like this is the way you can get channeled to the angels. I'll be having talk on angels also here. So this is you and your higher self. So it will be more of, this will be your ego self and this will be your higher self. So whom do you want to talk with? You want to talk with your ego self or you want to talk with your higher self?
Higher.
Yes, because the higher self will all have the solutions. The ego will have all the problems or the question marks. So when you have all these, shift to your higher self. When you have something coming up or you feel there's a lot of negativity, shift yourself to the higher self. That way you will not feel the burden and that will also shift your consciousness. And again, I always say, if you want to find the secrets of the universe, think in terms of energy, frequency and vibrations. Okay. So let's start sowing this seeds of consciousness in whichever ways we like to do. Like I just shared in this talk a few ways of doing it. I also have a workshop on this. It's like around 2.5 hours workshop where I tell you more in detail about various ways, in simple ways. And these are like the online recorded ones. You can just subscribe them and you can watch it at your convenience. No need to do a classroom studies for that. And so thank you very much. A big thank you and a heartfelt gratitude. And this is my email. If you have any queries, you can always write back to me. And if you don't have time to email, you can also WhatsApp me on these numbers. So whatever your queries, I will also add you to my broadcast groups. You, every day you will receive messages. I will guarantee that I won't disturb you throughout the day, but definitely the divine message, whenever it's required, it will be delivered to you. And it is happening with
so
many
young
people.
And having so much knowledge, it is absolutely amazing.
But the soul doesn't have any age. Thank you very much.
You are